Hello everyone, this is PiggyBank with another arms guide. Today we'll be looking at the latest character, Misango, that was added in the 4.0 update. Misango, aside from looking really cool, has a very unique and powerful mechanic that revolves around his guardian spirit. When Misango holds block and his arms charge up as a result, the guardian spirit will go in front of Misango as a pillar to protect them. I call this the pillar mode. The spirit will stay there until Misango lets go of block or the spirit deflects incoming attacks at least once. Even when the spirit deflects attacks, as long as Misango holds block, the spirit will come back after some time. Misango can wear the guardian spirit as a mask to change its attributes to best suit the situation. There are two ways to wear the mask. The first way is to fully charge your arm. When you do this, you're vulnerable for a short time, so use caution. The second way is to touch your guardian spirit when it is a pillar. So in theory, you can chain pillar mode into wearing the mask back to back. Once the mask is worn, the mask will stay on until Misango is knocked down by an attack, doing another full charge, or using Misango's block to activate the Guardian Spirit pillar mode. The Guardian Spirit has three color variants: red, yellow, and blue, each with its own attributes. The Guardian Spirit will change color in the order of red, yellow, and blue. However, when a round starts, the color that the spirit starts on is always random. The Guardian Spirit changes color on its own roughly every 1.7 seconds. Wearing the mask or activating the pillar mode will pause the color change. However, deactivate the pillar mode and instantly change colors. Now let's get into what each color does for Misango. The red mask will give super armor, make his arms larger, and increase his grab damage to 180 at the cost of mobility. The yellow mask will give Misango a barrier that activates when he uses a rush attack. Make sure to activate the rush while wearing the mask, as activating the rush then wearing the mask will not trigger the barrier. Also, wearing the yellow mask has the downside of decreasing Misango's grab damage from the usual 160 to 150. There are some information out there saying that this mask will decrease the rush damage, but I have not found anything that supports this. The blue mask will increase Misango's mobility greatly, but his arms will become smaller and, like the yellow mask, will decrease his grab damage to 150. The blue mask will also allow for two special dash techniques. While charging his arms on the ground, press jump to do a super dash jump. From a full jump, hold the jump button to charge, then press the dash button to do a grounded super dash. If you time this correctly, you can keep linking the two super dashes from each other. Another technique is to do the super dash jump, do an aerial dash, charge from the aerial dash into another super dash jump. Potentially, you can link super dash jumps back to back. Getting used to the Guardian Spirit may take a while, but once you do, you will find that Misango is an extremely flexible character that can fight in his own terms. If you are interested in the frame data of the Guardian Spirit's mechanics, then refer to the description below. Special thanks goes to Player Series, who's giving me information on the different colored masks, and to Ric Davis, who taught me how to do the super dashes. I hope that this guide will help you in mastering Misango. And with that, I will see you in another arms guide. Thank you for watching. Take care.